Children, welcome all to the IT class. In the last class, we had started our third chapter, The Infinite World Within Our Grasp. Today, we will continue the lesson. We have studied about email and how to create an email address in Google account in the last class, right? Today, let's see how we can send an email. For sending an email, click the compose button in the Gmail window. Type the receiver's email address, subject, and the detailed content in the respective columns in the window that opens. Then click on send button. At that time, you will receive a message that your mail has been sent. There may be differences in the arrangement of the facilities and buttons in the email box of various service providers. Now, to attach a copy of the invitation or notice with an email, we have to do the following thing. First, we have to select the file or the notice to be sent. And by clicking the Attach File tools, see the picture? In the new message window, we can attach them by following the instructions that appear when clicking this button. Then click on send button. In the same manner, we can attach pictures, videos, audio files, etc. along with the email and send them. While typing the email address of the person or persons to whom you wish to send the mail in the column label 2. You have to be careful. If you have to enter more than one email address, use a comma to separate the addresses. If you want to send a copy of the email to another person, enter their email address in the CC column, that is carbon copy column. If you want to send a copy of the mail to another person without the knowledge of the email recipients in the 2 and CC column, enter the person's email address in the BCC column, that is blind carbon copy. Once more, while entering the email address, we have to enter the email address in the column labeled 2. Then, if you have to enter more than one email address, that is, if you want to send the same mail to different persons at the same time, in the 2 column, you have to type all the address separated by a comma. Clear? The first point is about sending email to different persons, same email to different persons at the same time. Now, if you want to send a copy of the email to another person, that is, if we have already sent an email to a person and if we want to send a copy of the email to another person at a different time, then enter their email address in the CC column, carbon copy column. Then we will get the privilege to send the copy of the email selected. Okay. Now, if you want to send a copy of the mail to another person without the knowledge of the email recipients in the 2 and CC column, that is, the receiver and the carbon copy columns, then enter the person's email address in the BCC column, blind carbon copy column. It was Ray Tomlinson, who was an American computer programmer, who developed the program to send messages from one computer to another for ARPANET, which was a precursor of the internet. Actually, ARPANET was the preform of internet. He was the one who selected the symbol at the rate to separate the username from the name of the service provider in the email address. Even now, user at the rate host is considered as the standard for email address. Okay. Now, certain precautions are to be taken while using an email. First point, password is the key to enter an email box. Hence, It is safer to create a password that contains capital letters, small letters, numerals, and symbols. Otherwise, some other persons will hack your password. Second point, it is good to change your password at intervals to keep your email safe. Third point, sign out of your mail account after you finish using it. Fourth one, if you receive mails, attachments, etc. from unknown or unfamiliar addresses, you should open or respond to it only after ensuring its credibility, whether the news or the attachment is right or not. Last point, sending mails which include news, pictures or videos that are false, obscene or cause defamation to people or is a threat to national security is a punishable offense. Now let's move to the next topic, various modes of communication. You have learned the importance and advantages of email. Now let's compare the merits and limitations of various modes of communication. First one, letter. You have known it already. The main merit is that information can be exchanged in the form of text and picture. But it has some limitation. It causes delay to reach from the sender to the receiver. The letter, telephone. Merit, information can be exchanged in the form of sound. Instead of text and pictures, information can be exchanged in the form of sound. And the transmission of message happens very quickly. Now mobile phone. In mobile phone also, information can be exchanged in the form of sound, text and picture. And here also, transmission of message happens very quickly. Now comes the email. Through email, we can send text, picture, audio, video, anything. Okay children, this is the end of this part of the video. We will continue our chapter in the next class. If you have any doubt, ask me through the WhatsApp group. Thank you.